Good morning, children. Let us discuss how to control the environmental degradation. We have studied already in the previous class how industrial pollution causes environmental degradation. Our environment, our surroundings are completely polluted. How can we control the environmental degradation for sustainability? Now, every liter of waste water discharged by our industry pollutes 8 times the quantity of our fresh water. How much of water, waste water we are sending out, we are letting out, creates the fresh water to be polluted. So how can the industrial pollution of fresh water to be reduced? There are some suggestions. Minimizing use of water for processing, reusing and recycling it in 2 or more successive stages. We have to minimize the use of water for processing. Whatever in industries, we have to reduce the use of and also reusing and recycling it in 2 or more successive stages. We have to do it. We can reduce the use once, first of all, and reuse the used water. Again, we can use. How we can make it purifying, then we can use it and recycle it. Harvesting of rainwater to meet water requirements. Rainwater harvesting. Rainwater, we know that it is a very fresh water that can be collected or stored for the future purposes. Treating hot water and effluents before releasing them in the rivers and ponds. So hot water after completion of, after the use in the industries, it has to be made cool, then only to be sent to the release them into the rivers and ponds. Treatment of industrial effluents can be done in 3 phases, especially how these effluents or waste water or materials in the industries can be treated before sending them into, before releasing into the water bodies. Primary treatment by mechanical means. How this involves screening, grinding, flocculation and sedimentation. How we can gathering all these clay-based materials, removal from the water. Then flocculation means gathering all the clay and waste materials from water, and the sedimentation, removal of sediment all from this water in the waste material or water, then make it purifying. Secondary treatment of biological process, and third process is biological, chemical and physical process. So these are all involving in the recycling of waste water, then it becomes pure water, fresh water can be released into the water bodies, or whether it is ponds or rivers or lakes, etc. Now, overdrawing of groundwater resource by industry where there is a threat to the groundwater resources also need to be regulated legally. We know that they should have some laws or rules to be, norms to be made. How overdrawing groundwater. Groundwater is completely we are taking out, and so that the level of groundwater decreases. There are some limitations to draw out the groundwater also. Particulate matter in the air can be reduced by fitting small stacks to the factories with the electrostatic precipitators. We know that we can fix in the, especially in the industries, we can find smoke pipes are there. Smoke is continuously emitting into the atmosphere, but we need to make some small sort of smoke stands so that this can filter the toxic air. Okay, before releasing into the air, the toxic air will be filters. So fabric filters, scrubbers and inertial separators, these are all can be used so that the air, toxic air will be purified, or fresh air can be sent into the atmosphere. Smog can be reduced by using oil or gas instead of coal in factories. So coal also produces smog. So that if instead of coal, oil or other gases are used, so that smog also can be reduced. Machinery and equipment can be used, and generators should be fitted with the silent. prevents us. We know that noise pollution occurs from the generators, so that can be reduced to other machinery or equipments if we are using silencers. So silencer if used so that the noise pollution can be reduced. Almost all machinery can be redesigned to increase the energy and efficiency and reduce noise. Now the modern machines are, now we can make new machines or old machines can be redesigned so that increasing energy and efficiency also reduce the noise also. So the machines newly should be produced which should have a less noise pollution. So noise absorbing materials may be used apart from personal use of earplugs and earphones. Instead of using earphones or earplugs, such kind of machines can be used which can absorb the noise also. So the challenge of sustainable development requires integration of economic development with the environmental concerns. Development should be taken place. For the development, we need industries also. Industries are must for the development of any economy. At the same time, for sustainable development should take place. So when we, without damaging, without degrading our environment, we have to develop industries. So here, NTPC is a major power providing corporation in India. It has ISO certification for EMS, Environmental Management System. So NTPC is a power providing corporation which has a ISO certificate. So here the corporation has a proactive approach for the preserving the nature and our natural environment and resources like water, oil and gas and fuel in places where it is setting up power plants. So wherever NTPC is setting up power plants, they have some processes before setting up the how this nature should be preserved. So without polluting water, oil and gas and fuels, all these have to be preserved. So nature friendly industries they are setting up, optimal utilization of equipments, adopting latest techniques. So maximum utilization of any equipment using the latest technique, modern techniques, and upgrading the existing equipment. So what are the machines already we are using? It's upgradation and modernizing taking place and the latest technology so that nature should be protected. Nature friendly machines or equipment should be made. Minimizing waste generation, minimize or reduce the waste generation or maximizing the ash utilization. Ash to be utilized maximum and reduce the waste generation also. Providing green belts for nurturing ecological balance. Our ecological or environment friendly or ecological balance should be maintained. Addressing the question of special purpose vehicles for afforestation. And afforestation also to be taken place. We know that we are cutting the more and more plants and trees, so deforestation is occurring. At the same time, gives importance to afforestation, planting more and more trees and increasing the area under forest cover or green cover. Reducing environmental pollution through ash pond management, ash water cycling system and liquid waste management. So here reducing environmental pollution, that means using ash largely, burning the trees, burning the dry grass, etc., dry grass or leaves, ash creation. Ecological monitoring, reviews and online database management for all the its power stations. Wherever NTPC is setting up industries, they are following all these methods in order to make our surroundings or nature also considering the nature protection or protecting our environment and nature also. So these are all about the manufacturing industries. How in this chapter we have studied how industries are set up, what are the rules and regulations or norms to be followed in industries in order to protect our environment. So what industries also we have studied, industries are necessary, at the same time sustainable development also has to be taken care. Okay, so that is the chapter here under, and we will study about the next coming class, we will study about the new chapter, Lifelines of National Economy.